Hey guys, today we're going to show you how to remove your headlight out of your Sierra or your Silverado. I have this 2015 Sierra 3500 in the shop today, and we need to remove the headlight in order to do our snowplow wiring harness. So the 2500s are a little bit different than the 1500s in terms of, I've seen 1500s where this trim comes all the way down. So we get a little bit of a break because we have to remove this to get the headlight out. Now that we have the top part removed, to remove the grill, just grab your hand in the corner and pull, and just pull towards you. Then you're gonna go around the perimeter, unclip the whole thing and remove it. So to start, we'll remove the 10 millimeter bolts that are easy to get at. You can see that there's one down here and two up top. Next, we're gonna remove, there's a 7 millimeter underneath the plastic trim over here and a T15 Torx. So this next whole part is, I kind of disagree with how newer vehicles are being built because it's extremely layered and there's a lot of plastic. And since they're not that old, not a big deal, but I'm not sure how well these parts will last when they get to that 10-year mark. So with those fasteners removed, you can pull this forward and the tape's gonna release off of this clip, but then you'll be able to remove the rest of the pushpin clip. So for whatever reason, that's double-sided taped on, they don't clip it. And then you can just turn it off to the side because now we have to pry this piece out. So this part's a little bit tricky, and there is, these are clipped over, the plastic trim is clipped over this black part. So what you have to do is you have to pull it forward and you're going to take a flathead and you have to kind of jam it in there and release it. So what I'm doing is I'm putting the screwdriver here or a panel release tool and I'm lifting up. That will release the little tabs that hold this all together, and you have to go all the way around. So you need to work your way around slowly, then you can grab back here, pull it towards the back of the vehicle, and then you can release that. I've already released these, lifting up, so these come up and out. You know, GM had it right in roughly 99 to about 2007 Classic, 2006, where the headlights were a pin, and they come out and you have the whole assembly out. Here you have to really mess with these plastic pieces to get these headlights out now. Okay, here's the part where it feels like you're doing something wrong, but it's the only way I can see to get this out. So this is layered underneath this. So I push the headlight housing back and I pull this forward and that gets this piece out. So I don't understand why it's built like that. I completely disagree with it. That's how you have to get it in and out. I want to say it's built that way in terms of production, but in terms of serviceability, it's just really difficult. So now we can remove this 10 millimeter and then this 10 millimeter. So this might feel like the headlight just won't come out. Don't worry, there's a tab right here. Lift that out. Now your whole headlight assembly comes out. All right, so we got our headlight assembly out. Now we can go ahead and do whatever you need to. Fishing through here just seemed way too difficult. So removing it gives us more room to do our snow plow. Also, I had to fix this. I have another video for it. You don't have to take off the headlight housing if you don't want to. You can grab it from underneath. It might be very difficult, so just do this all in one shot. Take this plug out, put dielectric grease, plug it in a few times to clean it off. Your horn will come back. Because I know a lot of you of this age range, 2014 and to 2018, a lot of your horns aren't working. In my other video, I show that this actually gets soaked with quite a bit of water, so dielectric grease will not only restore it back to performing the horns working again, but also help protect it. And there is my fix for the horn. So a piece of ABS plastic screwed into the bracket. And I kind of actually learned this from, if you look at late 90s, early 2000s Savannah vans, if you go here on the driver's side, there's the PCM. They actually have a little rain track, a little piece of plastic that goes in the fender area to sheet away water. So exact same concept. So as water drips down off the headlight housing, this will block it and then should prevent any issues later down the road. So you see here is all my plow wiring, easy to get at, everything's clamped, and I am routing it in a way that if there's an accident, it's less likely to pinch. You don't want to be near metal when, if the bumper were to cave in. Access can happen, there's only so far you can take it, but you need to think that way. We also don't want to chafe due to vibration as well, so we were clamped everywhere, zap strapped everywhere we can. Also, I'm dielectric greasing any plug that I have out or that I can access while I have everything all apart. Now you guys saw that I took it all apart with an impact. But when I put it back together, I'm doing everything by hand because it's plastic and it's not the most durable. And depending on what kind of tools you're using, you might have something that's really high torque. So just slow it down on reassembly and hand tighten everything with a ratchet and snug it all up. Now, before we put any of the trim pieces back on, we want to make sure that our headlight housing and everything works properly. All right, so reinstallation of the bottom trim is, well, it's just plain hokey. So I grab a tool like this to give me lots of surface area, and that allows me to push down on it and get underneath that plastic bracket. So I find starting from the fenders easier and making sure you rotate it forward, and then you can get into position. And again, we grab our tool. And then we can start realigning the clips and then clicking it all back together. When you're done, it'll all go back in the same way. You just have to really watch. Don't just start, you know, banging on and just forcing it in. Really look and aim where those clips line up, and then it'll just all click back together. So take that clip out, put new double side tape on, and then you can just click on this flare. Where you guys have it, not a horrible job, just a couple tricks dealing with the lower portion of the headlight. If I can give GM any feedback, please bring back your serviceable headlights. But until next time, guys.